Now it turns to part four.
Part four.
Listen to the last part of the lecture. As you listen, complete the notes below.
First, you have some time to look at questions 31 to 40. Now, listen carefully and answer questions 31 to 40.
Last time, I said that a lot of Irish people left the country and went to England, America, and many other foreign countries. Today, I'd like to talk about the emigration. The effects of immigration were not all bad. The immigrants experienced a lot of hardship in their new countries. There is a famous story about a park in Shanghai, where Chinese and dogs were not allowed. Well, in England, until into the 1950s, signs for jobs sometimes read, "Irish need not apply." The immigrants often experienced discrimination, but they formed many organisations to look after their fellow immigrants. Many of these organisations later became very important. In America, the Irish chose politics as the way forward, and significant cities were controlled by Irish politicians. This movement reached its peak with the election of John F. Kennedy in 1960. His grandparents came from Ireland, and his election had a significant impact in Ireland, helping the process of recovery of self-confidence, which we have today. Today, there are 70 million people of Irish descent living outside Ireland. In America alone, there are 40 million people, and 10 million of these people have 100% Irish background. They carried the culture of their home country with them and adapted it to their new home. They made changes which would be unthinkable in the home country, and we often laughed at the Yankees' Irishness. In fact, any immigrant who came back to live in Ireland, often after many years, found it very difficult to fit into Irish society again. They had been changed by the experience. These immigrants have always had an interest in the old country. The American letter was a letter containing dollars sent back to one's family. More recently, President Clinton has been very influential in bringing peace to the north of Ireland. Riverdance itself was the idea of a dancer who was American, who applied American methods to traditional dancing, and the fusion was immediately popular. Modern Ireland has been able to use the disaster of the last century to learn modern marketing techniques and apply them, without at the same time losing what is distinctive about itself. Riverdance is a demonstration of that distinctiveness.
That is the end of part four.
You now have half a minute to check your answers.